We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
First of all, is this visible to you all? Arithmetic coding PDF, is it visible to you all, the PDF file? You can just answer.
No, ma'am. Yeah.
Okay. Good. First, before introducing the problem to you people, I would want to explain it once again to all of you. So, arithmetic coding is a very important problem. Most of the time it has been asked, at least once every time. So in arithmetic coding, first thing that they would ask you is creating a tag and deciphering a tag. What exactly are both of these? Creating a tag is nothing but encoding, and deciphering a tag is nothing but decoding. Okay, so there are two different ways of asking it: either encode or create a tag, or decode or deciphering. So this particular problem that you see now on your screen, encode B, C, A, D, D using arithmetic coding, this is taken from GTU exam paper. Okay, I think in 2017 it was passed. So this particular problem, what they have asked you is, you have to create a tag, that's all, encoding B, C, A, D. So how exactly this particular problem works is, first of all, you will have to check how many different characters are present in the given string. So in this particular string, you have B, C, A, D, B. So how many different characters? You have 4 different characters, A, B, C, and D. So in the examination, they will give you a string. Along with that, they will give symbols along with their respective probability. And the third column that you see on the screen, which is the interval, that is what you have to calculate. Okay? They will not give you the interval. You will have to calculate the interval yourself. So symbol and probability are these two things which will be provided to the student, and the student has to calculate what is the interval, which is very simple. So I will just explain how the interval occurs. So initially, A has a probability of 0.45, B has a probability of 0.25, C has a probability of 0.15, and D has a probability of 0.15. So calculating interval is very simple. Interval always varies between 0 to 1. So, and we go in always the alphabetical order. Likewise, the interval of A begins with 0 and goes up to the probability of A, which is 0.45. Next symbol that occurs will be B, that has a probability of 0.25. So how do you get the interval? Interval is where you have stopped at the previous symbol, which is 0.45, start from there. So 0.45 plus 0.25, which comes up to 0.7. So 0.45 to 0.7 is your interval for the character B. Same way, you have to calculate for character C, which is 0.15. So start with 0.7, add 0.15 to it, you get 0.85. And the last character that is present is 0.15. So you will have to start with 0.85 and add 0.15. You get the final interval. Here, the hint or the trick is, if you have calculated correctly, you will end up at the value 1 at the end of your interval. Clear? So this is done. Next, you have to take up the string and start encoding. So the first character is B, and B's interval is already given. We know what is the B's interval, that is 0.45 to 0.7. So you do not have to apply the formula that you see in front of you, L of n and U of n. Okay, this particular formula comes into help when you are encoding the second character and after that. Yeah, the first character, we have the interval right in front of us, that is 0.45 to 0.7. Now, from your exam point of view, mostly your exam may be MCQ based for your GPU. So you should be prepared with everything. You should go in depth, in detail. So you should know how exactly the formula is. So they may even ask you to propose a formula. They may tell you pick the right formula. So in that case, you will have to know how exactly your formula is. Word to word, you will have to study. So these are the two formulas in order to calculate the subintervals. So L of n, that is the lower side of your interval. UN is the higher side or the upper part of the interval. So LN is equal to LN minus 1 plus UN minus 1 minus LN minus 1 of f of x, xn minus 1. So same way, you have a very similar formula below that. That is for calculating the upper side of the subinterval. So first part is almost the same. The only thing that changes is the function, fx of xn. So always you have to keep in mind is L and U, wherever it appears, it is with respect to the previous interval's value. And fx means it is with respect to the current interval's value. So now we know what is the first character, that is B, and what is its interval, that is 0.45 to 0.7. We will start encoding from the second character, which is C. The second character, it lies in 0.7 to 0.85. So 0.7 to 0.85 will become your current interval. And the previous character to C, which is the previous character to C, B, what is its interval? 0.45 to 0.7 will be L and U value. Yeah? So L means lower, U means upper. So L will be 0.45, U will be 0.7. Yeah? Yes?
Well, we are not able to hear your voice clearly. Sure.
Okay, I think there's some
disturbance.
Are you able to see at least?
Yeah, we are able. Yes, we can see.
Okay. Now, can you hear me? Do you want me to repeat anything?
No, ma'am, but there is something disturbance.
I think that is the network issue.
Yeah.
Right. If you want me, I'll explain whatever you have missed. Tell me where you have not caught up.
नहीं मैम पता तो चल रहा है मैम
पता चल रहा है अगर नहीं चल रहा है तो बीच में मुझे बोल देना
या
ओके सो व्हाट आई वाज एक्सप्लेनिंग इज इन दिस एंटायर फार्मूला एल एंड यू इज विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द प्रीवियस कैरेक्टर्स इंटरवल एंड एफ मींस द करंट कैरेक्टर्स इंटरवल सो वी आर इन द सेकंड कैरेक्टर दैट इज सी क्लियर द सेकंड कैरेक्टर इज सी सो इट्स करंट इंटरवल विल बी 0.7 to 0.85, clear? And the previous value, that is B, its interval is 0.45 up to 0.7, clear? So that will come in LNU. FXN minus 1 will be the current character's subinterval, which is 0.7, and FXN will be 0.85. We'll move to the next page. So here, you can, if it's not visible, you can just zoom in and see how I have solved. Clear? So what I have to do is, in every character, I have to create subintervals. That is what I have to do for every character, starting from the second character. So now we are in the second character, which is C. So I will be calculating L and U value. So I told you, L and U are with respect to the previous character. So wherever L appears, you have to use the L value, which is 0.45. That is the interval of character B. Right? And U value is replaced with 0.7, which is again the upper interval of the character B. So just substitute it. Then coming to fxn minus 1. So fxn minus 1 is the current character, which is the current character now C. Its lower value, which is the lower interval 0.7. So I will replace fxn minus 1 with 0.7 and I get my final answer as 0.6250. So that is one set. Now coming to the upper subinterval, the first half of the formula is absolutely the same. So same thing, you will have to replace L and U's. The only difference is in fxn. This time, if it is not fxn minus 1, it is fxn. So I will have to replace the current character, which is C's subinterval, in that the higher value or the upper value, which is that 0.85. So whenever I do that, I just have to calculate them. I will get the value as 0.6625. So my new subinterval will be 0.6250 up to 0.6625. So this I have to always keep in mind, because I will have to substitute this subinterval again when I try to encode the third character, which is character A. So now moving on to the third character, which is character A. Now again, wherever L and U appears, that is Ln minus 1 and Un minus 1, I will have to replace the new subintervals that I have just calculated. So first will be Ln minus 1. Ln minus 1 is the lower part, which is 0.6250. Then Un minus 1 will be the upper half of the interval, which is 0.6625. So same way, I will replace all of them. And one more thing, what I have told you, fxn minus 1 and fxn. So what is that? That is with respect to the current character. So we are in which character? We are in the third character, that is character A. What is the interval of character A? Character A's interval is given in the first table that I just showed you in the previous page, the third column. Interval column gives you interval of A from 0 to 0.45. So I'll just scroll back. Here you can see A's interval is 0 to 0.45. So same thing I will have to replace here while calculating the third character's subinterval. Again, fxn minus 1 is always the lower half, so that will be 0. Fxn will be the upper half, so that will be 0.45. Simple calculation, you have to just substitute them. You can use a calculator. You will get your final answer as 0.6250, that is L value, and U value will come up to 0.641875. Always make sure that when you get digits of varying length, that is here you can see L and U value, after the decimal point, there are only 4 digits in L, whereas in U, after the decimal point, there are 6 values. So what you can do, you can append zeros, okay, at the end. So you can round off this value from 0.6250 to 0.625 and 3 zeros, okay, after that, just to make it equal to the value, to the number of decimal values that are there in the U value. Here, so that will be easy for you to know where exactly this particular digit stands, right? So like this, I will continue. I will get a new subinterval, which is 0.625000 up to 0.641875. So this is my new subinterval. Now, we have not reached yet the end of the character. We are now in our fourth character, which is character D. Again, same way, I will continue. What I will do, I will again replace whenever there is L n minus 1 and U n minus 1, I will replace L's, all L's with 0.625000 and all U's with 0.641875. And wherever there is fx n minus 1, I will replace that with the lower interval of D. What is the interval of D? We'll just scroll back. D's interval varies from 0.85 to 1. So that means fxn minus 1 is 0.85 and fxn will be value 1. So keeping that in mind, I will again replace that. So here you can see the first value is calculating the value of L. I have replaced fxn minus 1 with 0.85. I get the value as 0.6394375. This is my value which I get for L. Same way, I will replace, instead of fxn, I will replace that with 1 and I will get the value as 0.641875. Again, to equalize both the numbers with same length, I will append 2 zeros at the end of U, that is 0.641875. I will add just 2 zeros to it to equalize both of them. So this is the end of the fourth character. Now we have come to the final character, which is character B. So the fifth character is character B. So again, I don't have to explain it in detail. By now you may have got the idea how to calculate. So wherever there is L and U's, replace it with the previous subinterval, that is the new interval that you have just created. And wherever there is fx n minus 1, replace it with the interval of b. So interval of b, again we'll just go back. Interval of b varies between 0.45 to 0.7. So first I will replace, in place of fx n minus 1, and replace it with 0.45, and the next fx n, and replace it with 0.7. So finally I will get the answer as 0.64048281.25. That is the first half of my subinterval, and it varies up to 0.64111.5625. So now you have come to the end of your string. So what was the string given to you? The string given was BCADD. You have encoded all the characters one by one till the last character, which is character B. So this marks the end of the encoding process. They have asked you to calculate tag. So how do you calculate tag? Tag is nothing but finding a value, a fixed value that lies in between the final subinterval. Which is the final subinterval? The subinterval that is on your screen that you can see now. There, you can select any number that lies within this range. That is from 0.64048281.25 to 0.64111.5625. You can even select the first number, that is 0.64082812.5, or you can select the last number, that is 0.64115625. Or you can even take an average of these two numbers. Add these two divided by 2. So even that can be done. So just to make it more simple, I will select the very first number that is there in this interval, which is 0.64048281.25 as my tag. So if they are in the examination, if they ask you to create a tag, then you're supposed to follow all these methods which I just explained. Creating interval, creating subintervals for every character one by one till the end of the last character. And finally, you have to zero down on a fixed number. You can't give an interval as your answer. Tag is always a fixed number. So any number you can choose out of the interval that you get from the last encoding value. Yeah? So this is about encoding tags. Does anyone have any issue in understanding? If I was not clear, please let me know. Did you all understand? Say a yes or a no. Am I audible? Hello.
Yes, ma'am, clear.
Okay, fine. Good. So now I'll move on to the next one. Next problem is encode and decode BACBA. This was again asked in the examination. How do you encode and decode BACBA with arithmetic coding, where the probabilities of the three characters, that is P of A, P of B and C, are given 0.5, 0.3 and 0.2. So again, this is important from the exam point of view. They have asked you here to even decipher a tag. So you may have come across a question in the exam for arithmetic coding where they will ask you to create a tag and decipher a tag. Deciphering is nothing but decoding the tag. Yeah? So you will have to decode and explain how do you get back the very same character or the string, which is BACBA in this example. So how do you decipher and get back that particular tag? So again, I would not explain the encoding part. So I would want this particular session to be interactive. So I want you all to come up with answers. Fine. So all of you take a pen and a paper with you. And calculation is very simple. So like I told you, you can solve it yourself side by side. I will give you answers. I'll give you time to solve it. Clear? So first of all, you have three symbols A, B and C. Probabilities are already given in the question. So 0.5, 0.3 and 0.2. The first thing that you have to do is you have to calculate the interval. So calculating interval is very simple. I told you interval always lies between 0 to 1. So the first value that you start is 0. up to the probability of the first character is 0.5. So the first interval is between 0 to 0.5. Second character is B, its probability is 0.3. That means you will have to start with where you have stopped. So your previous interval, that is interval A, is varying in between 0 to 0.5. So from 0.5, you will have to start for the next character, which is 0.5 plus the probability of the character B, which is 0.3. So 0.5 plus 0.3 will give you 0.8. So that is the range or the interval for character B. Next, moving on to the last character, which is character C, so the probability will be 0.2. So you will have to start with 0.8 plus 2, you get the final answer as 1. So I told you always interval, the trick is you have to end up at your interval 1 as your last one. So now that we have got the interval, you can apply the same particular formula which I just explained, and then you can start solving. Yeah. So I'll give you just five minutes time to solve the first character. The first character is B. So that its interval is already given to you, 0.5 to 0.8. So don't waste your time solving that. Move to the next character, which is character A. So there what you have to do, you have to take up this formula and you have to just calculate L and U. Wherever you come across L and U value, replace it with the previous character, that is character B's interval, 0.5 and 0.8. And wherever fx n minus 1 and fx xn appears, you have to replace it with the current interval, which is the current interval A. What is its interval? A's interval is 0 to 0.5. So you will have to replace here. So now, in another 5 minutes, I just ask you what is the answer for the next time. So you all can start solving it. Please don't leave the meeting.
Mem 0.65 and 0.74.
0.65
and 0.74.
Second character के लिए है ना?
हाँ, second character के लिए.
हाँ, L value 0.5 आएगा. और U value 0.65 आएगा.
अरे मैम, मैंने सेकंड कैरेक्टर बी लिया है.
नहीं नहीं, चेक द स्क्रीन.
मैं फर्स्ट का 0.5 एंड सेकंड का 0.65.
हाँ, आता है, करेक्ट.
हाँ,
ओके. व्हाट अबाउट अदर्स? पृथ्वी, उत्कर्ष सो गए या फिर है मीटिंग में? Am I audible to all of you all?
Yes, ma'am.
What about others? You can answer. Okay, fine. Abhi, we'll start with the next one. Now that we have solved the character A, we'll move to the next character, which is that next character will be third character C. Fine. So third character, try solving and tell me what is the answer that you get. Now you will have to replace 0.5 and 0.65. कितना आंसर आता है अभी?
मैम 0.62 एंड 0.65.
गुड, 0.62 एंड 0.65 आ गया. तो यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हो इतना आ गया होगा L and U value. So you have replaced 0.5 and 0.65 everywhere. L and U ke jagah mein. Or 0.8 will be fxn minus 1 and fxn will be 1. Correct? That is the interval of character C. So aise karke aapke aayega final answer 0.62 and 0.65. Abhi kya karna hai? Next character will be character B. Abhi isme kya karoge aap? You will replace 0.62 and 0.65 in L and U value. And you will get the answer more or less. This you can just write down 0.635 to 0.644. This will be your subinterval for the character B. Same way, I will continue for the last character, which is character A. So I will replace with all L and U's with the previous subinterval. Jo humne previous character mein mila hai, wo kitna hai 0.635 and 0.644. Isko sare jagah mein substitute karna padega. L and U में and fxn minus 1 and fxn that will be your current interval character which is that A. What is the interval of A? 0 and 0.5. So I'm replacing that. I will get my final answer as 0.6350 to 0.6395. So this is my final subinterval. So यहाँ पे क्या करना है? I have to calculate the tag. Tag कैसे मिलेगा? आपको कोई भी number इस interval में जो आता है वो नंबर आपको सिलेक्ट करना हो तो इट कैन बी 0.6350, इट कैन बी 0.6395 और एनी नंबर दैट लाइज इन दिस रेंज. और एक और मेथड है, आप इंटरवल का एवरेज ले सकते हो. तो लेने के बाद जो भी आंसर मिलेगा वो विल बी दैट विल बी योर टैग. सो व्हाट आई डू एवरी टाइम व्हिच इज द फर्स्ट इंटरवल वैल्यू 0.6350, आई टेक इट एज माई टैग. सो यू हैव सॉल्व द फर्स्ट हाफ ऑफ योर प्रॉब्लम. Now what you have to do, you have to decipher the tag. So deciphering the tag, what you have to do is you have to decode. How do you decode? Decoding is again very simple. what you have to do is you have to draw interval lines. How many interval lines you have to draw? That is based on the number of characters. Abhi is string mein kitne characters hai? B, A, C, D, A. So, 5 ho gaye. So, 5 lines aapko draw karna padega. So, yahan pe 5 intervals are present. So, 5 different lines I'll be drawing. After that, what you have to do is you have to divide each line based on the different types of characters. Now, again, go back to your string. The string asked in the question is B, A, C, B. How many different characters are there in this particular value? A, B, C. Correct? There is no other alphabet apart from A. That means your entire interval, that means these lines, are divided into 3 different parts. One part for A, other part for B, and the last part for C. Again, you have to place them in alphabetical order, starting from the last. So here you can see what I have done. I have divided this entire interval into 3 parts. Now again, how do you divide them? Starting from the left hand side, the first line on the left hand side, I divide this line between 0 to 1, that is the entire interval, into 3 parts, A, B and C. I will get from the first table that I had generated. Correct? So there I had created intervals for A, 0 to 0.5, for B, 0.5 to 0.8, and for C, 0.8 to 1. So this way I will create the interval. Next, what I will do, I have to apply a very simple formula again. So what is this formula? First, take the character which is given in the string. The first string character is B in our particular problem that they have given. The first character will be B. Next, what I should do, I should take the interval of B. Interval of B is ranging from 0.5 to 0.8. So I have to just find the length of that interval. How much is that? That is 0.3. So that length of my interval, I will have to multiply with every probability of every character in my problem. So first I will multiply it with probability of A. So 0.3 into probability of A. How much is that? 0.5. So 0.3 into 0.5, I will get 0.15. So now what I have to do, 0.15, I will have to add with the first starting of my interval. So actually what I am doing is, I have already created my first line, vertical line that you see. That interval is already created. I have divided it into 3 parts. Now I have to draw the second interval. So in second interval, what I will do, I will have to decode. So decoding means I know the first character is. So I will try to expand that interval. B's interval is lying in between 0.5 to 0.8. So my second interval will start from 0.5 and end at 0.8. So the second line you can see. Starting point is 0.5, ending point is 0.8. So now after this, I will try to solve the problem. So down you can see what I have done. I have multiplied 0.3 with probability of A. So whatever answer I get, here I have got 0.15. That 15 I will have to add with the starting point of my interval, which is the starting point 0.5. So 0.5 plus 0.15, I will get 0.65. So that will be the length of the interval A. Next, there are how many different characters? Next character is B. I will again have to divide this for creating interval of B. So now how will I do? Same thing. Entire difference, length of this entire interval is from 0.5 to 0.8. So entire length is 0.3. That should be multiplied with the probability of B. Probability of B is 0.3. So I will multiply that. I will get 0.09. So I'll just scroll down. You can see the calculation that I have done. So this is the one. So 0.3 to 0.3, I get 0.09. Add that to 0.65. So how did I get 0.65? Go back to the diagram. I have finished my interval marking up to 0.65, as you can see in the second line. So my starting point for B will be 0.65. Hence, when I multiply 0.3 with the probability of B, that answer I will have to add with 0.65. Please don't do the mistake of adding that answer to the very initial value, that is 0.5. Clear? So don't add it to 0.5. Add it to where you have stopped, that is 0.65. So I will add it to 0.65. I will get 0.74. So the B interval ranges from 0.65 to 0.74. clear? Now, coming to the last character, since C is the last remaining character, it is not required for you to calculate the probability again for C, because it is understood. Jo bhi bacha kucha, jo bhi hai jagah, that is exclusively for C. So don't waste your time in calculating again what is the interval of C. Clear? So we will leave it as it is. And now what we have to do, we will have to decode. So what is our tag that I have selected? Going back to my tag, how much is the tag? Keep this number in mind, 0.6350. So how I will decipher it is, you can see, first I'll start with taking only one digit after the decimal point, which is that one digit after the decimal point will be 0.6. 0.6 is automatically falling in that range of 0.5 to 0.8 in the first line, correct? So which is that character? Character B is selected. Next line I have already developed. So we will read two values after the decimal point of the tag. So what is our tag? 0.6350. So now I will read 0.63. So 0.63 again falls in which particular range? It is falling in the A character range, right? It is falling in between 0.5 to 0.65 range. So I have decoded the first two characters, that is B and A. Clear? Up to here, any doubt, you can please stop me in between, right? Now I will move on to the third character, which is character C. So how do you solve character C? Again, we will go back to our second line. In second line, we have deciphered character A. So which is the interval of character A in the second line? 0.5 to 0.65. I will expand that interval. So my entire interval, that is my third line, will vary between 0.5 to 0.65. Clear? So same interval, I will keep it as it is. Now again, what I have to do, I have to divide this interval into three different parts for three different characters, A, B, and C. Same way, what I'll do, first I have to calculate the subinterval for A. So first, before that, what I have to do, I should know the length of the entire interval. The third interval is ranging between 0.5 to 0.65. So what is the difference? Difference will be 0.15, right? So here you can see, difference is 0.15. This I will have to multiply. Same method I am following. I am multiplying with probability of A, which is 0.075. Now 0.075, I will add it with 0.5. I will get the answer as 0.575. First of all, why have I added this to 0.5? Because this particular interval is starting from 0.5. You can see that in your third line, right? The lowermost interval is 0.5. So I am adding that value to 0.5. So I will get 0.575. Same way, I will calculate probability B. I will multiply it with 0.15. I will get the answer as 0.62. So now you can see, I'll go back to the problem. Third line, you can see B is varying between 0.575 and 0.62. So that is my subinterval for the character. Again, moving to the last character, which is character C, do not calculate. It is understood that C lies in between the range 0.62 to 0.65. Now again, go back to your tag. What is the value given in your tag? Tag value is 0.6350. So now instead of two digits, read three digits after the decimal point. That will be 0.635. So now 0.635 lies in which range? It lies in the character C. That is, it is lying in the interval 0.62 to 0.65. So that particular character you will have to circle. Now again, one thing I would want to mention, in decoding or deciphering, circling is very important. Clear? So you will have to mention which character you are selecting in every iteration. Clear? So you can see I have circled every different character whichever is selected. So that circling is important. So I will decode and I will realize that C is the third character. So next fourth line, what I will do, I will expand or elaborate that particular range, 0.62 to 0.65. Again, I will follow the same very method which I told you. You can just check here. 0.65 to 0.62, I will get the difference as 0.03. That is the length of the entire interval. I will multiply it with probability A and B and get my new interval, which is 0.644 to 0.635. Fine. So I'll just go back to the diagram. So here you can see the last line, 0.635 to 0.644 is my integral. Again, I will apply same mathematical calculation and I will divide them and I will get my final interval as 0.635, which lies in the character A. So that is how I have divided all of them and I have decoded this value. So if you do this entire thing, that will fetch you full marks. But now, since your GPO exam may be MCQ based, so they may ask any particular section. They can tell you to just encode a particular value. So same thing, it's the same. You will have to apply same different method and you have to get the just that it won't be very lengthy. You will have to solve it within a minute or two, right? So I would suggest all of you to solve these problems one by one. You can just copy down whatever I have explained, at least the final answer. You can solve it yourself, right? Your final range for this after decoding will lie in between 0.6350 to 0.6395. If you get this range as your last value after decoding, that means you have solved it correctly. You can just make a note of this last line. Can I stop sharing now? Please say a yes or a no. Can I stop sharing next, please?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, does anyone have any doubt? You can stop me.
Ma'am, कोई नहीं है. सब चले गए. आपने बोला ना.
Okay, okay. एक मिनट. All right. तुम्हें समझ में आया ना जो भी कुछ मैंने सिखाया था?
हाँ मैम सब कुछ.
Okay. अगर कुछ अगर doubt है, you can always mail me or message me.
Okay मैम.
Okay fine. Thank you.
हाँ.